Last night when the class dress white, school saw us dress creature besides bed.
I'm the ghost of Christmas pet and get out of bed and come with me.
The ghost took Scrooge sometime to a small town, which Scrooge started to remember things from his past.
They cannot see us or hear us. They are just shadows from the past.
Then they arrive at a house. This house seems familiar. Oh, this is my house, where I grew up.
And do you recall that little boy sitting alone reading?
It's me, as a child, but why am I? Why is he alone?
You must know the answer.
Because my parents were working. That is why I was alone. That is why my Christmas was sad and lonely.
Come, take my hand. We don't have enough time.
No, I have said enough. Go away, don't torture me.
Do not blame me, I told you. These are those that have been.
Take me back.
We have one more stop, time is running out.
And they appeared in a garden. Scrooge was now a young man who was sitting in a garden beside a lovely young woman. The woman was crying.
Remember, Nisa, until you love me.
Nonsense, I love no other woman.
More than any.
Stop! Take me home.
And Scrooge appeared in his own bedroom.
Then the clock struck.
It wasn't a dream.
I love you all of Christmas.
I am the ghost of Christmas present. I have much to show you. Grab on to my robe. Hurry, we cannot be late. Scrooge touched the hand of the spirit's robe. The bedroom rest and Scrooge found himself on a busy, snowy street.
Ah, it's Christmas. How do you expect?
Then the girl took Scrooge to Bob Cratchit's house.
Then Scrooge saw Bob Cratchit playing with his children, three boys and two girls.
Is that where he lives?
Of course, with his salary, this is he can afford.
Now Miss Cratchit entered into the dining room carrying a small turkey on a platter.
Yes.
Bob Cratchit lifted the youngest boy from a chair in the corner and carried him to a table. The boy was pale and thin and carried a crutch.
Strong. Does he walk?
He's very sick. His name is Tiny Tim.
And his parents don't have money for a daughter, so maybe he will die.
Die, but that must be something.
How do you care anyway?
Scoot and the girl listen to Bob and his family have a wonderful time together.
Meanwhile, it was getting late. The girl took Scoot to different places so he could see how people celebrate Christmas. People who never see were poor, as Scoot used to say, they were happy and enjoyed being together with their families and friends. Then the ghost of Christmas parents was gone. As he sat up, another ghost floated into the room. He was dressed in black and a dark hood hit his face.
Who are you?
The ghost said nothing. He just got out the top the door. Scoot followed him to the tree in front of his office. Three women stood out front, talking and shaking their heads.
First girl.
I know I feel sorry for him. Was taking care of him. He doesn't have anything. The girl started whirling and Scoot followed him down the street. Then they arrived to a tiny house. We have been here before. This is Bob's house.
The ghost took Scrooge into the bedroom. There was Miss Bartrace sitting beside his huge bed. He was very sick.
Is he crying? Sleeping in bed was a little cat, but he was thinner and very pale. Mrs. Cratchit came into the bedroom.
The mother and father both looked sad and helpless.
Is he going to die? What can I help him?
I cannot show you what will happen, but you must see for yourself what may happen if no one helps this poor little boy.
Then everything turned dark and Scrooge appeared in a foggy and cold place. Why did you bring me here?
The ghost showed Scrooge a grave.
Is this the image of what will be? The ghost did not answer. He only pointed. Then Scrooge went to see the grave. Engraved on the headstone was the name, Ebenezer Scrooge. Then Scrooge fell to his knees.
Oh no, ghost, listen to me, Archie.
In his anger, he took the ghost's hand, but the ghost rejected him and Scrooge woke up in his bed.
Oh, thank you. I have been given another chance. I don't know what day is today or how long I have been given with a ghost. I feel like a child, but I don't care. I want to be a child again.
And Scrooge did really. He became a much nicer person and always helped others. He raised up Sherry and helped to take care of Tiny Tim.